Hey, what's up everybody? Cole here with Sage Outdoor Adventures. Thanks for visiting our website, YouTube channel, wherever you're at. Hey, just wanted to give you an update on winter 2022. The snowfall started out pretty slow in November and December, and then just before Christmas, one of the biggest storms I've ever seen here in Colorado hit, and it didn't stop snowing for 10 or 12 days. And by our measurements, we had about 10 feet of snow fall on the Sage private snowmobile mountain here. We're to the west of Vail and Beaver Creek, about a half hour drive, which means we got a lot of southwest storm flow and a lot of northwest and west storm flows. We get storms that hit this area specifically from a lot of different directions, different than like say the Vail or Beaver Creek ski areas. Sometimes they get more snow than we do too, but out of this storm, you know, when Vail was getting to 6 to 10 inches, we were getting 16 to 20 inches. It was just crazy. It was awesome. And, you know, the snow has settled out a little bit now. There's not 10 feet of snow sitting on the ground. The wind came up and has scoured certain areas and loaded other areas. But yeah, the point is the snow has arrived. It's January 15th of 2022 today. And it looks like it's going to be a fantastic rest of the winter. And that will obviously lead into an excellent summer of rafting on the rivers when all the snow starts to melt. While I've got you, I'm going to give you a quick tour of the views up here. This is one of our main trails. I'm not even close to the top of our mountain here, but this is a great vantage point. We can see a ton of stuff from here. So let's get into it. This is my snowmobile. You can see I've got bamboo poles on it here. I'm marking our trails out. When it's whiteout conditions, you can't see much unless you got bamboo markers. So, okay, we're looking directly west here. We've got the chasm of Glenwood Canyon. Just beyond that, the Book Cliffs and Roan Cliffs of the Rifle area. And to the north of that, just this little mesa up here is not a very little mesa. That is the Flat Tops. That's the southern end of the Flat Tops that extend north all the way to Steamboat Springs. As we look more southwest, we are actually looking in the direction of Aspen. But in our way from actually seeing Aspen, we've got this long ridgeline that's called Red Table Mountain. And Brush Creek. I'm looking pretty much south right now up Brush Creek, and that's the US West phone tower that's up here high on the property as well. Still looking basically due south, we get into the Sawatch Mountain Range. That is a very long mountain range that contains a lot of the collegiate peaks in Colorado. We're looking at the very northern end here. It extends south all the way down toward past Leadville and Buena Vista and has a lot of famous mountains in it. The big one on the left side here with that big dark face on it, that is a 14,000 foot mountain called Mount of the Holy Cross, well known to the Vail area. And then as we look southeast, we're looking at both the Vail and Beaver Creek ski areas. I'll zoom in a little bit here, but let's see. That's the Beaver Creek ski area right there, and that is the Vail ski area right there. Hi! There goes one of our guides on some mission. I don't know what they're doing. That little V right there, that white V, is Game Creek Bowl at the Vail ski area. And then all those ski runs to the left of that are the front side of the Vail ski area. Just over the top of those ski runs, slightly to the left, that big snow-capped mountain, that is the Continental Divide. And over by the Copper Mountain ski area and the Breckenridge ski area. And then just to the left, we've got the very rugged Gore Mountain Range. I'm looking basically due east right now. You got some unbelievable 13,000 foot beautiful mountains right there. And looking northeast, it's extremely hard to see, but way, way out there, those mountains that are way in the distance and kind of hazy, that's actually Rocky Mountain National Park. And then to the north of us, we can't see because of that hillside there, but up there's Steamboat Springs. You can actually see the Steamboat Springs ski area from the very top of our private mountain here. So. Anyway, that was a quick overview, but you know, I've probably stood here on this spot like 1,000 times over the past 10 years of guiding here, and the view never gets old. I always come up here, my jaw drops, and I'm just like, holy smokes, look what I can see from right here. So anyway, thanks for visiting the site. We look forward to having you as a guest. If you're coming to Vail, give us a call or book online, and we'll go have some fun on these things right here. Snowmobiling's awesome. All right, thanks.